For anybody who needs to understand the bidirectional, this is a simple diagram of how the bidirectional actually is. If you're a constructor and you're interested in bidirectional construction, you need to get this concept from the beginning. If you have it from the beginning, then you know where you safe hands to start with. So the next thing we want to enable the parts of the biodigester, we are looking at a rectangular something, a rectangular shaped box, typically a rectangular shaped box that has been divided into two. Inside the digester itself, we look at this, and then the bearing and everything that is also inside can also be looked at. But basically in this video, I'm going to give you an understanding of how the biodigester works and how you can use it as an option in terms of your human waste management. The next is the digester. This is the top slab. So in my case, in most of the digesters, you see a handle, right? Somewhere here. That in case you want to lift and inspect or do some work in it, you can lift this part and then have some work done in it. And then you can also have the clean out here, or a clean out can be here, which is the inspection chamber, basically that you can use to look inside the digester to see how it's performing, whether there's water in it and how it's working, whether it's working to perfection, as you might like. But basically, this is how the digester is. And then let's say this is 2 feet. This is the standard, digester, so you're looking at 2 feet here. It's the same as here, 2 feet. And this is here, 2 feet. And then maybe this is 6 feet. So this is also 2 feet, right? And then this one can be 2 feet by what? By four feet. The short part will be 2 feet, and then here will be 4 feet. And this you need to take the whole thing off. Then when you come, this is where the separation is. You take this part off, and then you see. So this is your inlet is the one that's coming from the house. If you do control the bidirectional for somebody, and they're not going to use it right now, you are supposed to get an inlet, leave the pipe there for the plumber who will come and connect every digester, who will come and connect every single toilet in the house. If it's a 3-bedroom house and you're doing a standard farming center digester, maybe there are 3 toilets. And then there will also be a 4th one, which is the guests on visitors one. So you have 4 toilets. And then if a plumber comes, he's supposed to bring all the pipes and come and then connect them to the inlet, which is what you need. In some cases, because the pipes are scattered, you might need another inlet, let's say somewhere here as well, and another inlet here as well, so that it can come from here, it can come from the back, or it can come from the side, depending on how the house has been located. And then where you are locating the bidirectional, you might have to give one or two, or even sometimes 3 inlets. But we always advise that you minimize the amount of inlet that you provide, so that at least the digester can work well based on the fact that the toilets are coming in at a particular case, and then it's being distributed evenly on the surface of the digester bedding, and then it can cover a longer use. So you have your inlets, and then you have your outlets, right? So in our case, let's say this is our outlet. Our outlet is needed to where? This is the shape pipe, we call it the shade, or the black water pipe. The toilet water is the black water pipe. And the kitchen and the bathroom water is what, the gray water. So the black water pipe is what you order the initial pipe, the shape pipe, and the PVC 3 inches or 4 inches pipe. 3 inches probably is only 3-bedroom house. 4 inches, because maybe it's a larger digester and then you need a lot of space for the water to go. You have 3 options for your bio digester in terms of where the water is going. You have the soak away, you have the soak wall pit, you have the soak away, and then maybe you have a drainage system. That's a gutter just by the end of your road where you can pipe into them and then to take them away to get the kitchen, the bathroom, wastewater. So the soak wall pit is where you need the small stones or some broken blocks in them. Then you fill it in the brim. And then you use a black rubber to cover it, and then you connect the pipe into it, so that when the water comes in, the rapid separation separates the water, and then it drops straight into the so-called pit, and then it permeates the surface of the earth. You also say groundwater is not affected simply because if your digester is only 2 feet and we are going to bury, let's say, two and a half feet, and this is the one that's going to show at the end, 2.5 feet will not affect groundwater, right? Because groundwater, you are thinking about, let's say, the borehole, if you do a normal manual digging borehole, you are looking at least 20 feet, sometimes 50 feet, sometimes more than enough feet before you can see the water that you need. If you are doing a mechanized borehole, you are looking at 200 feet all the way down. So that's why we say when you do a digester, groundwater is not affected. It's the main reason why they also work in waterlogged areas. This is the main reason, because you are not going to go deep. As far as you were able to build your house in that waterlogged area, a digester can also go there. Because the foundation that you dig, and then you did all those works, and then you build your house in that waterlogged area, and there's no way that digester is going to go to the level. Because the digester will only be picking the level from the pipes, the inlet pipes that are coming from the house, so that it can go inside. So the digester will not go anything, no more than 4 feet. That's why we say they do work in waterlogged areas. So that's one of the reasons why. So groundwater is not affected. People have to soak whole pit, which is the first option for your biodigester. Most of the traditional biodigesters that we did, the understanding was simply because homeowners or low-income houses are having manholes and this traditional unhygienic toilets that you see the flies and everything are all over it. And the biodigester scale. So the initial idea was that let's do soak away, cost effective, use locally sourced materials, let's do soak away just for the digester to wet. And then you can maximize the use of the amount of water in the house that you need to flush, because you don't need too much water in the digester, which is another thing. But we have to always let the water out of the digester into the soak hole pit. And then we can take any stones in the area and then we can use them to fill it. And then we can put the fine coarse sand on top here. And then we can cover it. And then you can go ahead and use it. The water will just sit through here and then come here. And then you have your digester and then you're good to go. But with time, others also adopted it. Homeowners who are building their houses and they are using the septic tank decided, I know, let's also take this. It's cheaper. It's economical. It can easily be placed. Can be sited anywhere at the backyard. Maximize your land. You want to maximize it. You also think about the environment. Well, you don't need a truck to come and destroy the feces in the scent and the smell. So let's adopt this method, because obviously it's working. Government has approved of it. The World Bank has approved of it. They have funded some of these local areas. And it's something that can work. But then we've also realized that because of the amount of water that's coming into the so-called pit, if you do this digester for a 4-bedroom house, and then you have a so-called pit, and the ground is not roomy soil, are you sandy? Which of the sand that you take is the best for a so-called pit? Let us know in the comment section below. And then we'll give you a thumbs up. So the sand is not good. It's a clay. It's waterlogged. And then you cannot do a so-called pit. The next option is to do a soak away. Right? Whereby you lay the blocks. And then you do a top cover for it. You put a clean up on it. And then you can access it later. You connect your pipes to it. And then it's part. So you have two things now. You have your digester separately. You have the soak away separately. The traditional soak away that you use for soaking the water from your drainage system in terms of your kitchen at the bathroom, you can use that same soak away just for the digester. Separate the water directly into the soak away, and then you can permeate the earth surface. But because you have done a block wet, you can always have access to the water here. So if it's a clean area or it's a waterlogged area, a pump can be put on this soak away and then can continuously submissive pump when you get to a level, or manually, you can pump this whenever you realize that the water is not moving from the digester. You can pump this way, then any water here will still come back here, and then you can pump it. So there's some also came up, some people, environmentally conscious homeowners also came up and said, I want to use this water. What can you do about it? We say, well, fine. We are treating it here, but we can do a harsh treatment and do further treatment for this and do some treatment here so that you can use this water to water a garden or any flowers that you have in the house. Then at least you are saving the environment. And then the third one which is what has also become very common, is the drainage system, whereby the pipes from the digester can be straight pipe into the drainage system, and then the wastewater can be taken away. Sometimes DPA do not approve of it, sometimes they approve of it. But let's say you do the digester in a local area, most of the water in that gutter or in that drainage system is even worse than this water that is coming from your toilet. So that water is allowed in it. I've done commercial biodigesters in some part of Ghana that have been allowed. DPA has given me certification to put the water in the drainage system. But it comes with a caveat, and it comes with a condition, which is that you do a lot of filtration here, and then the water will have to be tested to make sure that it meets the E. coli level. There's an EPA standard that the water must meet before it can be allowed in the drainage system. So you do that one. Let's say you are doing it for a restaurant, or you are doing it for a bar, commercial use, and then you have to meet all the EPA certification. When you do consider a biodigester, what you do is to have this water tested at when you start using it, have it collected and tested, and then you get a certification from the water research institute to make sure that you meet that standard, which the EPA will give you approval for you to be able to dump it in the gutter or in the drainage system. So basically, this is a simple understanding of what the biodigester is and how homeowners can use it as an option in terms of managing their human waste water.